Oh shit.
Is this recording? I really can't see.
What the fuck is up, everyone?
This isn't the video. But hear me out. I'm gonna try to speak fast. No one wants to hear like the 10-minute merch pitch. So I'm gonna keep this short and simple. I made merch, but this isn't your average merch. This isn't just the same old. This is a little bit different. I've been talking about mental health and I've been a little bit open about that this year, and I thought it would be kind of cool to sort of make something that was kind of like a little reminder to be compassionate and to be a good fucking human being. So this is the merch.
What the?
My neighbors are gonna like murder me in my sleep. This is the merch. It says smile at someone today, and I really fucking love it so much. If you don't know, this is actually a Mac Miller reference, and as someone that loves Mac Miller, I think that just makes it a lot more cooler than it is. The cartoon deeply satisfies me and like scratches that itch in my brain. It reminds me of like 90s cartoons. I could go on and on about the design and all of it, but I'm excited to be sharing this with you guys. This is genuinely some of the softest material that I've ever laid my hands on. Just look at the inside. What the fuck? It's so soft and comfortable and warm, and I'm just gonna say it, the company that makes my merch also makes Cody Co's merch, and if you've ever bought Cody Co merch, y'all fucking know how good that quality is. There's so many different designs and pieces. There's t-shirts and long sleeves and crew necks and sweatpants. Anyways, I could literally go on and on and on and on. But the thing I'm most happy about and excited about, all of the proceeds of this merch are gonna be going to a mental health charity. I'm looking into mental health charities, and as soon as I get all that information, I will put it in my description box so you guys know a little bit more of where this money is going to. I really wanna give back this season, and I wanna give back to young kids, teenagers, young adults all around the world that struggle with this shit, because this shit's real and sucks. If you're interested in giving back and donating, or if you just wanna get a cool hoodie, you can check out my store. I don't know the name of the store. Who just like remembers that shit off the top of their head? Hold on. NileaDeboraShop.com. Or you can click the link in my bio. It'll lead you to the website.
Okay.
Everything will be available tomorrow at 10 a.m. All right, I love you guys. Enjoy me burning my kitchen down again. Hey, ladies and gents. Welcome back to my disgrace of a cooking show. It is midnight, so we all know what that means. It's time to cook shit up, and it's time for my downstairs neighbor to hate me. I'm so sorry. Okay, I let my chicken sit in the fridge a little bit. Let's check it out. Ew, is this what smells bad? Oh! Okay, I left this chicken in my fridge overnight because it told me leave chicken in fridge for at least 4 hours, overnight preferred. And they are stinking up my fridge. I opened my fridge today and I was like, damn, what the fuck is that? It was this! That makes so much sense. The recipe said to let these chill for 20 minutes. I'm gonna leave them there for like 10 and I'm gonna get started on this oil. I'm scared as fuck. I hope I don't burn myself. Let's get started. Says I need to put the canola oil in here. I think I'm just gonna have to use a whole bottle of oil. It says to start gently heating it. Oh, this is gonna be so gross. Why am I wearing like my cute white girl outfit right now? I whipped out the brand new Melville right now to fry chicken. Okay, we're gonna put it on low and we're gonna get started on everything else. Baking powder, what even is, I thought baking powder was baking soda. I don't have baking powder, guys. What the fuck do I do?
I do have flour though. No need to fret. We got flour this time.
I need 2 cups of all-purpose flour. And then I have to put 2 little pussy teaspoons of baking soda. What is that baking soda gonna do? 1.5 teaspoons kosher salt. That's a lot of fucking salt though. We need buttermilk, 2 large egg whites. You know, I feel like women that don't know how to cook actually have the fattest asses. Actually, wait, that's literally not true. How do I take this egg yolk out? It's gonna literally crack. I just need to grab it with my hand. That's so gross. Fuck it, fuck it, fuck it, fuck it. Ew.
Ew, it cracked on my hand!
And we need 2 tablespoons of vodka. No one asked me how I got this. 2 tablespoons of vodka. We're gonna put 3 for a good time. Mix it all together. While I do this, I'm gonna rate high school for you guys. So for all of my high school girls,
I just graduated. Actually, no, I didn't. It's already been 2 years. What? Freshman year. I'm gonna give freshman year a 3 out of 10. I was still finding myself. I had negative social cues. I was fresh out of my emo phase. Freshman year was a lot. I now have to coat my chicken, so. Wait, this is actually kind of fun.
And
then we put it on the side. When my future husband asks me how I learned to cook, I'm gonna be like, sophomore year was fun. I think sophomore year I actually started making friends. I started making friends with men. So I was like having all sorts of crushes. I thought they were in love with me. They weren't in love with me. I went to like football games all the fucking time. I was like, sorry mom, I'm not coming home tonight. I got a football game to go to. Sophomore year, I'm gonna give it an 8 out of 10.
Go fried chicken, go fried chicken.
Junior year of high school. My junior year of high school was fucking terrible. I hated it. That was the year, that was the most stressful year. As you guys know, we had SATs, college essays. We had the whole shabazz. And now, here we are. I'm in my fucking apartment cooking fried chicken by myself. Ladies and gentlemen, oh shit. Ladies and gentlemen, Ray's here.
What are you making?
Well then why do you bring food?
Well, I don't think this is gonna be edible.
I'm about to start frying it.
Oh.
I really don't know how to fry it.
Do you have like a fry like cover? Wait, what is this for?
I'm cooking. I wanna be a chef now. This looks like a turkey.
That looks good.
No, it doesn't. Does that look like southern fried chicken?
Nope.
Yes, it kind of does, bro.
Wait, does it?
Yes, it looks good.
Wait.
That looks good.
Ah! Okay, I'm gonna wait for these three pieces to finish frying, and then we're gonna do a taste test. Ray is gonna be brutally honest. Right, Ray?
I'm not gonna lie, I think that's like the raw one.
Yeah, I don't want the raw one.
How do we feel about the texture of the chicken?
Okay, it looks crunchy.
Okay.
Good, listen to it.
There's no way you just crunched it.
Okay, ready, cheers.
Bonk.
Okay.
Chew it.
Yeah, I think this one was raw.
I'm happy about it.
You're lying.
No, like I'm not.
You're lying.
That is cooked. I'm gonna rate mine because yours looks a little scary. I think it just needs to be cooked on a little higher.
Okay.
I'm gonna go with a 8 out of 10.
You're lying.
I'm happy. I would eat this.
Are we trying the same chicken?
Yes. Wait. Get the crunchies because that's the best part. Yeah, crunchy. That's good. Yeah.
I wanted it to be more bready.
I'm disappointed.
You know what I'm saying? I wanted like a little like Popeye's bready chicken.
Well, it's like real chicken. You know what I mean? It's not like processed.
I'm gonna rate mine a 4 out of 10.
Yeah.
Wait, did you take another bite?
Dude, I will.
What? That's literally the thumbnail. That was it. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video.
You guys say anything?
I'm sorry I never have eyebrows in any of the videos.
Literally what? Bye! Like and subscribe.
Actually, don't do it.